Hello, everybody. My name is Eric D. Johnson, also known as Black Shine. I live right here in the city of Memphis. It's in the state of Tennessee. It's in the county of Shelby. And today's date is early Sunday morning, February 26, 2017, time 3:37 a.m. First thing, thank you all my fans, my support for your continued encouragement and support. Anti-gang, and I continue to keep myself employed right here in the city of Memphis, tri-state area. I continue to further my education at Morrow College Online, pursuing my social research and business and concentration marketing. And on today's video, the music you hear in the background, using string in the African nation of Gambia. And Radio Cairo, Gambia. The African nation of Gambia. So, hello to everybody in the African nation of Gambia as well. Hello to everyone everywhere. And before I do my Instagram, hello, everybody. My name is Eric D. Johnson, also known by the side. I live right here in the city of Memphis. It's in the county of Shelby, in the state of Tennessee. And today's date, early Sunday morning, February 26, 2017, time 3:39 a.m. And first, I thank you to all my fans, my support for your continued encouragement and support. And, want to say thank you to all the men and women serving today in the United States Armed Forces, and them and their families in our thoughts and prayer. And say thank you to all the men and women in law enforcement, and them and their families in our thoughts and prayer. And thank all the men and women, public servants, elected officials, and all the men and women that are employed, federal, state, and local, and living our families in our thoughts and prayers. On today's video, I'm going to continue to thank God first. Thank God. And also, for all my Instagram listeners, viewers, the African nation of Gambia, and we use the streaming at a radio station. We listen to Radio Cairo Gambia. Like I said, I want to say thank you to God first. Thank God for all his blessings and his guidance. We thank the United States government for the Organized Crime Control Act as well as the RICO Act, the Racketeering Influence, Corrupt Organizations Act, the United States Government, for the Juvenile Justice and Delinquency Prevention Act, the United States Government, for the Comprehensive Anti-Gang Initiative, the Comprehensive Gang Model, the United States Government for Violence Prevention, the United States Government for the Anti-Gang Strategy, we thank the United States Government for all that they do to try to make our nation, our communities, our districts, our neighborhoods, and our homes safe from crime, organized crime, and gangs. We thank the United States Government for all that they do. We thank God for guiding this nation as well as all nations around the world. Thank God. You know, again, on Instagram, you know. We're going to end our Instagram, anti-gang. Periscope. You ready to do Periscope? I Come on, everybody. My name is Eric D. Johnson, also known as Bryce Stanley, right here in the center of Memphis, in the county shields in the state of Tennessee. Today is the early Sunday morning, February the 25th, 2017, time 3:49 a.m. And to all my Instagram, to all my Periscope fans, of course, viewers. Music here in the background, we're using streaming. It's the African Nation of Gambia. African Nation of Gambia. It's Radio Cairo Gambia. Radio Cairo Gambia. Video. Turn the music down. For today's video, we're going to continue to talk about African traditional religion. As you know, African traditional religion is being taught at institutions of higher learning, meaning colleges and universities. In sub-Saharan Africa, you can earn bachelor degree, PhD, studying African traditional religion. Now, we're going to look at a map so we can know where sub-Saharan Africa is located. This is an African language distribution map. African language distribution map. Now, it shows you the people that live on the continent of Africa, and it shows you the language that they speak. Now, that blue color, that represents the Afro-Asiatic. That yellow color represents the Nilo-Saharan. The dark orange color represents the Niger Congo A. The light orange color represents the Niger Congo B, the Bantu. Now, this is the other half of the map, as you can see. On the side, it shows you that the blue color represents the Afro-Asiatic. The yellow color represents the Nilo-Saharan. The dark orange color represents the Niger Congo A. The light orange color represents the Niger Congo B, the Bantu. That green color represents two groups of people. The Kwai people, the pastoralists, the sand people, the hunter-gatherers. Now, over there on the island of Madagascar, that purple lavender color, that's the Austronesia. The Austronesians are the people that live in Indonesia. Now, the people that live in Indonesia, they left Indonesia, migrated. They settled and colonized the island of Madagascar. They're not the original inhabitants of the island of Madagascar. This is Niger Congo language distribution map. Niger Congo. Now, the Niger Congo language is the primary branch. The Volta Congo, South Volta, Bantu on the side, Bantu. Your other East Benue Congo, your West Benue Congo, and your Kwe. Your North Volta, your Kru, your Sanufo, your Girl Volta language, your Adamawa, your Budgie language. Your other primary branch, your Kordofan, your Mandi, your Atlantic, and your Dogon. Okay, this is a Niger Congo language distribution map. Niger Congo language distribution map. Your Atlantic brand, Wolof and Fule. Your Mandi, Bambare, Malinka, Manika, Dayule, your Kru, your Girl, more languages, your Kwe, Bali, Akan, Iwo, Dogon, Ajor, Adamawa, your Bunji, Jabaye, Banda, and Zambi, your Kordofanian, your non-Bantor, Yaru, and Igbo, Bantor, Fang, Tiki, Lingale, Mungo, and Kondu, Congo, Choki, Lube, Luganda, Rwanda, Rundi, Sukume, Kikuyu, and your Bantu, Swahili, Makawe, and Yanje, Bimbe, Shone, Tsange, Northern Soto, Zulu, Southern Soto, Kosa, Tiswane, and Dange, Mbundu. There are many other Niger Congo speaking groups of people that are not listed on this map. This is an Afro-Asiatic language distribution map. Afro-Asiatic language distribution map. Afro-Asiatic languages. Large language family, several hundred related languages and dialects. It includes languages spoken predominantly in West Asia, North Africa, the whole of African parts of the Sahel. Now, the Afro-Asiatic language family includes the following branches: Berber, Chadic, Cushitic, Egyptian, Omotic, and Semitic. This is the Nilo-Saharan language distribution map, Nilo-Saharan. Nilo-Saharan languages are a composed family of African languages spoken by some 50 to 60 million Nilotic people, mainly in the upper parts of the Chari and Nile rivers, including the historic Nubian, north of where the two tributaries of the Nile meet. The languages extend through 17 nations in the northern half of Africa, from Algeria to Benin in the west, from Libya to the Democratic Republic of the Congo in the center, and from Egypt to Tanzania in the east. Now, some of the major languages of the Nilo-Saharan: Luo, Kanuri, Sangay, Tiso, Nubian, Lubare, Nandamar, Wida languages, Lango, Dinka. Now, the Lango language, that's a Luo language, Dinka. Now, Acholi, that's another Luo language, Nua, the Maasai, in Gambay, your Fur, and your Tubu. Before we get to our reading, you understand, we had to address some issues. Okay, I'm gonna pick up with that. Thank you. some of the issues that we have to deal with right now. Some of it personal and some, you know, general. But like our, you know, previous on my previous video, I reached out to the lady and ladies that I grew up with, my childhood, sweetheart, and everything. You know, elementary school, junior high school, high school. And I made it perfectly clear. Excuse me. Made it perfectly clear that that gang stuff went right. And that gang stuff, that foolishness, that nonsense was wrong. It was wrong yesterday. It was wrong today. It's wrong tomorrow. And because of that gang mess, you know, it had a very negative effect, you know, on my childhood and on my adult life as well. A very negative effect on my childhood and on my adult life as well. And I know definitely that her life has been negatively affected by gangs. And one of the things that I want to make sure that I don't never do is not keep myself informed and give her the impression that you don't have that you're not informed about things that you need to be informed about, because there's so much influence, negative influence out here in the community. So what I want to make sure I do today is get something cleared up about that gang stuff, because it's wrong. And when it's wrong, when I say it's wrong, just like that, having sex, you know, like I said, I told it on my previous video, you know, I won't go never, ever make my childhood sweetheart feel like, you know, that you're going to get mad at me because things didn't go the way you wanted to go. Between the way I already know that the game influence is the reason why we not together today. We don't have no child together today. And the reason why you did the things you did and said the things you said, and because of that gang stuff, and it was wrong. And like I told you before, when it comes to having sex, whoever you had sex with, that's why I killed. I killed that dude. And I mean it. And it's right. That's the right thing to do. That's right. I kill that dude. Ain't no way in the world you're going to tell me no game. You're going to go around trying to influence other people's family, especially the women and the children, are going around telling people you're a gang member. Like that's something that, you know, like you said, like you know, you give people the impression like you Jesus Christ. I'm a gang member. So what? You understand? But I did some research, and the reason why I did some research, I want to make it perfectly clear about that same reason that I killed that dude. You ain't got no business touching my girlfriend. You ain't got no business touching her. She ain't got no business having no child. She ain't got no business having sex. She ain't got no business being no gang, period. Now, there's a lot of information on the internet. And I did some research, legal research, on the law. See, that's the reason why it's wrong. And the first thing I want to make sure you see, the word coercion and coerce and sexual coercion. See, that's wrong. See, that gang stuff is wrong. Well, all the little girls and all the little boys, look that word up, coercion spelled C-O-E-R-C-I-O-N, coerce, C-O-E-R-C-E, and sexual coercion, S-E-X-U-A-L, sexual, and coercion, C-O-E-R-C-I-O-N. Coerce, and sexual coercion. I did some research. Go to uslegal.com. And that's another word I want to make sure that's included. Because when you do when you look up coercion, this word here is going to be included. Psychological manipulation. Psychological manipulation. For all the little girls and little boys to know the reason. That's one of the biggest reasons why gangs are growing. Psychological manipulation. Spell psychological. P-S-Y-C-H-O. L-O-G-I-C-A-L, manipulation, M-A-N-I-P-U-L-A-T-I-O-N, psychological manipulation. And when everybody can see it, psychological manipulation. See, that's the reason why I tell my childhood sweetheart, that's the reason why it's wrong. And then I leave a message for my family in Chicago. That's the reason why it's wrong. Now, let's go online. Let's go to uslegal.com. uslegal.com. Coercion. C. Coercion. C. O. E. R. C. I. O. N. Coercion. Let me scroll up here. Okay, the coercion law and legal definition. Let me click right here. Now, let me give you the categories. You have coercion, you have marital coercion, you have coercion and intimidation defense law, you have coerced confession, doctrine of coercion, psychological coercion. What to do if I was coercion to give me custody of my children? Coercive proceedings law and coercive diplomacy law. It's grounds for invalidating a settlement agreement. So but there are many categories. But we're going to go to coercion the law. Now, coercion generally means to impose one's will on another by means of force or threats. Coercion may be accomplished through physical or psychological means. It may occur in a variety of contexts, such as unfair trade practices, which prohibits coercion to sell insurance in most states. The definition varies by state and federal law. For example, one state defines coercion as a crime when a person compels or induces a person to engage in conduct which the latter has a legal right to abstain from engaging in, or to abstain from engaging in conduct in which he has a legal right to engage, by means of instilling him a fear that if the demand is not complied with, the actor or another will cause physical injury to a person or cause damage to property. See, such as, for example, when we be talking about anti-hazing, and we be talking about the sorority and the fraternity and being hazed, and if you don't agree, if you don't consent to the hazing, you still, just like joining the gang, and you hear about a lot of little girls and little boys in neighborhoods, they be intimidated, they be threatened, you understand, their mom and dad, they told them not to join the gang, and they're on their way to school, or at school, they get, get threatened, they get intimidated by other children, coercion, physical injury, threats, physical and psychological, coerce physically and psychologically. Now, it's a legal definition. This, let me see what. Psychological coercion, that's what we're looking for. Let's go over to psychological coercion. Psychological coercion includes theories of mind control, thought control, or brainwashing, claim that a person's mind can be controlled by an outside source. A confession is involuntary when coerced by psychological pressure. However, psychological coercion does not render a confession per se involuntary. Now, psychological manipulation. Now, psychological manipulation is a type of social influence adopted to know about the psychological vulnerabilities of your opponent. It is usually adopted to know what tactics are likely to be the most effective weapons against them. Psychological manipulation changes the perception or behavior of others through underhanded, deceptive, or even abusive tactics. Such methods are often considered exploitative, abusive, devious, and deceptive. It is often used in an attempt to control the behavior of others and uses various forms of psychological abuse, brainwashing, or bullying, emotional blackmail to coerce others to do things which they naturally do not want to do, like having sex. It is also known as emotional manipulation. Now, let's go over here, the sexual coercion. There's some categories. You have aggravated sexual assault. You have statutory rape law. You have juvenile sex offender law. You have trial rape, sexual abuse law, commercial sexual exploitation of children law. You have the Alabama mandatory reporting laws. You have elder law abuse law. Is verbal abuse considered a form of assault? Okay, and what exactly does attempt to commit sexual battery mean? Okay, so let me get back to you. So okay. Okay, aggravated sexual assault is a felony sexual offense governed by state laws, which vary by state, is typically defined as a sexual assault that maims, wounds, or disfigures the victim, or involves a victim who is physically or mentally incapacitated. It may also be defined to include a sexual assault that is aided or abetted by another person occurring during commission of another crime, or involves use of a deadly weapon. Local laws should be consulted for specific requirements and applicable penalties. Okay. pay the animals. Okay? He said the following is an example of a state law dealing with aggravated sexual assault. An actor is guilty of aggravated sexual assault if he commits an act of sexual penetration with another person under either one of the following circumstances. Number one, the victim is less than 13 years old. Number two, the victim is at least 13 but less than 16 years old. And A, the actor is related to the victim by blood or affinity to a third degree. B, the actor has supervisory or disciplinary power over the victim. C, the actor is a foster parent, a guardian, or stands in local parentage within the household. Number three, the act is committed during the commission or attempted commission, whether alone or with one or more other persons, of robbery, kidnapping, homicide, aggravated assault on another, burglary, arson, or criminal escape. Number four, the actor is armed with a weapon or any object fastened in such a manner as to lead the victim to reason believing it to be a weapon and threatened by word or gesture to use the weapon or object. Number five, the actor is aided or abetted by one or more other persons and the actor uses physical force or coercion. Number six, the actor uses physical force or coercion and severe physical personal injury is sustained by the victim. Number seven, the victim is one whom the actor knew or should have known was physically helpless, mentally defective, or mentally incapacitated. Now, so, I want to make sure that's very clear that that gangster is wrong, and the word coercion, let me say, come back over here. So I want to make sure I leave this information there. And my childhood sweetheart in there, and pay attention. And as you can see, that gang stuff is wrong. And when it comes to having sex, see, that gang stuff is wrong. And that person that you had sex with wasn't right. It was wrong to influence you in that way. That's coercion. And coerce. And sexual coercion. Psychological manipulation. See, it's wrong. Don't listen to the game. And while we're on this topic, we'll get to our reading. And then we're going to look up some words. Here in the city of Memphis, you know, we're still talking about the so-called gang. Take care. Okay. Here in the city of Memphis, you know, we're still talking about that gang situation. And the gangs are wrong. Individual attempted to make a fool out of everybody and to make everybody look like we stupid. And, you know, we thank God every day. Thank God is God. And thank God, you know, he blesses us with his guidance. And that gangs is wrong. And we thank God for the United States government. Because the United States government being guided by God, individuals, they make laws such as the Organized Crime Control Act, the Racketeering Influence Corrupt Organization Act, and the Juvenile Justice and Delinquency Prevention Act, which is they all anti-gang, the Comprehensive Anti-Gang Initiative, the Comprehensive Gang Model, Violence Prevention. The form that we on youth.gov and youth.gov that we was reading about, the form all around this country to prevent violence and gang violence and anti-gang strategies. You understand, gangs is wrong. The United States government making it clear it's wrong. So here in the city of Memphis, an individual attempted to deal with him and some more individuals in the gang. Attempted to make me and everybody else look like we stupid by talking about a gang truce and call itself and make a movie. But like we just got through talking about gangs is wrong. First of all, when you see the when you read your Bible, God makes it perfectly clear in his word. When we read the Old Testament, God tells you it's wrong. When God destroyed man in the book of Genesis with the flood. Remember we reading the story about the flood, and God gave a reason because of man being wicked and imaginations of his heart, evil continually. God destroyed man. See, what you're doing is wrong. We go to the New Testament, Jesus, the Son of God. In his word, he tells you that I'm the Son of God and the things that you're doing is wrong. He tells you in his word, the book of Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John, Jesus doing the talking. So here in the city of Memphis, individual called himself going to have a gang of truth. Some guy named Ladell Beeman founder and CEO of Heal the Hood Foundation. He thought he could make me look stupid. Thought he could make everybody else look stupid. Talking about a gang truth. Then he'll make a movie. Him and some more gang members. And but like I said, don't spend too much time on it. Everybody else, you can look it up. You can go to WMCActionNews5.com and you can read about it. But the point we're going to make, the point that's going to be made today about a gang truth and about gangs. First of all, gangs are wrong. And talking about a gang having a truth. Just like we were talking when we were talking about the National Gang Center, the compilation of state laws against gangs. See, the government is telling you the gangs is wrong. They're telling you it's wrong. So what you want, a gang truth is senseless. But still, you still in a gang. It's just two rival gangs who won't have a conflict anymore. But then all them other gangs that's walking around, you get into a conflict with them. But these two rival gangs there, they won't have any conflict. See, you, I'm not stupid. And the general public is not stupid. See, if gangs are wrong, that's what the United States government did, the National Gang Intelligence Center. See, the United States government is telling you gangs is wrong. See, all that taxpayer money, when we be talking about all these different efforts that the United States government, you see how much money the United States government is spending, taxpayer money, the FBI, the United States Marshal, all the federal, state, and local, the GREAT program, gang-resistant education and training program around this country. You see all the taxpayer money that the United States government is spending against gangs, and you talking about a gang truth? I'm not stupid, and the general public not stupid, especially the federal, state, and local government. They're not stupid. It's wrong. It's wrong. Gangs is wrong. There shouldn't be no truth. See, that's the reason why the Center for Disease Control and Prevention, they have a program, Change in Course, which includes the National Institute of Justice, which is the, and also includes the Department of Justice and the Office of Justice programs. All these federal agencies all working together. And then you sit there talking about a gang truth. See, it's wrong. See, gangs is wrong. And see, the Center for Disease Control and Prevention, they also have a program, Strive, striving to reduce youth violence everywhere. See, the United States government is spending so much money, taxpayer money, federal, and then the state government and local government, spending all this federal, state, and local taxpayer money against gangs. And then you had a nerve to talk about a gang truce. It's wrong. Gangs is wrong. Now we're going to get to Irene. We're going to go to Irene on African traditional religion. And then we're going to look up some words. Like I said, for everybody that's listening, read about this story, about the gang truce. Is you can go to WMCActionNews5.com. And the title of the story is Rival Memphis Gang Members Make Truce in a Movie. So let's get to Irene. And we're going to start out reading from the book titled West African Traditional Religion, written by Dr. Joseph Omosei Malelu and Dr. P. Adenumo Depemu. We're going to be reading from chapter 8, Mysterious Powers, and we're going to be reading from 8:2, Sorcery and Witchcraft. We pointed out in chapter 5, magic can be good or bad, licit or illicit. Bad or illicit magic is known as sorcery. It is offensive and antisocial. It is much feared because it can be used to kill, to harm, to destroy life or property, to make a happy destiny an unhappy one, and to disrupt the well-being of the individual and the society. A person who uses bad magic is called a sorcerer. He is an evil person, feared and hated. He very often works in darkness because his deeds are evil, and he tries to harm or kill his enemies or those of his clients who have paid him by evil magical means. Nail, hair, spittle, sweat, urine, washing water, sleeping mats, dirty clothes, chewing stick, and footprint are all connected with the body, and some may use them. May be used to prepare an offensive magic against the people to whom they belong. Great courage, therefore, taken in the disposal of these things. Various techniques are used by the sorcerer to achieve his ends. He may kill an enemy by means of an invocation, an incantation, and this he makes an effigy of his victim. And with the aid of some magical preparation, he invokes the spirit of his enemy by calling him by name. He then shoots a dang gun or an arrow at the effigy. He believes that whatever his enemy is, he will be shot and killed. At times, the magical preparation is in a calabash. After calling the victim by name, the sorcerer immediately smashes the calabash with a club. He believes that the spirit of his enemy is present and has been crushed. Many are known to have been killed by this means. Another method is by sending some poisonous things like a snake or scorpion or an animal to attack the victim. It is believed that if such animals are killed, they will be found to contain no blood. There are cases of those believed to have been bitten by magical snakes or animals, and they do not usually recover from the attack unless a powerful magic is found to counter it. Among the Yawuru, one technique of sorcery is called Megun. Do not mount or do not have intercourse with. A jealous husband secretly puts this bad magic on his wife without her knowing it. Any person that has intercourse with a woman is sure to be caught in the trap and to die a disgraceful death, and if by accident the husband himself mates with the woman, thinking that some other people have carried away the Megun, he himself will fall into the trap set for others. There is also the practice of cursing an enemy with bad magic called Ipi, curse with Ipi. A person can become insane or mad, misbehave, lose all things, or commit suicide. However, it is believed that a more powerful Ipi can be used to remove the evil effects of a previous Ipi. This is why the Yoruba say Ipi, Lefa, Nwoi, meaning a curse can be used to cure a curse. Furthermore, some sorcerers have the power to call down lightning upon their victims. There are those that can cause elephantiasis of the leg, and there are those that specialize in direct poisoning. Witchcraft is another practice feared by all. It is an act of the wise. It is the belief that the spirits of living human beings can be sent out of the body on errands of doing havoc to other persons in body, mind, or state. Witches are therefore those that possess the inherent psychic power to send out their spirits invisibly or through lower creatures to harm others or do havoc to other persons. Witches are called Obayifo, Azi, Aji, Amozu, and Twi, Fun, Yaru, and Igbo respectively. They are said to operate in guilds, though they can also operate singly or individually. It is believed that they operate through birds or some other animal familiars. Witches creatures are mostly women, but men can also be found, especially at the head of the gills, which is usually inherit their nefarious art from their mothers. Some are born witches while others are proud witchcraft. But witchcraft can also be bought for a small amount. It can be passed on through food. Witches operate mainly at night. They meet in guilds, but the meetings are spiritual. That is to say that the meetings are mainly the activities of the souls. Only the souls attend the meetings. At night, witches are thought to leave their bodies asleep in their houses while their souls fly off through the air to a meeting. They may fly on the backs of birds or animals, or actually turn into owls, bats, or black cats. If the animal is killed, it is believed that the real body of the witch at home will die at the same time. Witches are said to meet on the top of trees like Iroko or Baobab, where they perform various activities. They suck the blood or eat the soul of their victim. This is a sort of spiritual cannibalism. Mostly close relatives are donated as victims. Thus, a new member must bring a victim, usually a child of her own family, and the witches cook or eat the limb spiritually. When they eat the heart or the liver, the victim dies. There have been confessions of women to witchcraft, and a lot of what we know of witchcraft actually comes from such confessions. We must take such confessions as valid, since the women they confess are not usually forced to do so. They confess voluntarily, although there are a few cases when trial by ordeal may lead to confession. However, there are cases of old women confessing their guilt on their deathbed. From all that we have said, we conclude that West African people's literate and illiterate alike really believe in the existence of witchcraft. They know that witches are antisocial members of the society, and that they are the implacable enemies of the society in which they live. They are very potent and are thought to be responsible for all sorts of misfortune, accidents, stillborn children, sudden death, poverty, barrenness, and a host of human miseries. Although they are usually evil, yet some witches are sometimes thought to be good. Some claim to protect their families with witchcraft, but such are known to belong to no guild, but operate on their own. Witches cannot be fought openly. A man may not know the witch that is troubling him until the oracle declares it. For this reason, diviners, prophets, medicine men, magicians, witch doctors, and priests are consulted for help. Many people wear charms to defend themselves against witchcraft attack. We may conclude by saying that witchcraft is a problem with no immediate solution, since people continue to live in fear of it. But as people advance in education, perhaps belief in it will be reduced. Stop at that at this point right there, and okay, we just read from 8:2 Sorcery and Witchcraft. We read from chapter 8, Mysterious Powers. From the book titled West African Traditional Religion by Dr. Joseph Omosei Venado and Dr. P. Adenumo of the Penguin. we're going to continue our reading from the book titled African Traditional Religion and Definition, written by Dr. E. Beloja Adoro. Okay, we read from chapter 5, the structure of African traditional religion. We read from number 5, the practice of magic and medicine. It is also significant that more often than not, the collection of ingredients and the dispensing and application of medicine are accompanied by some form of ritual. Invocations proper also have their place in Sikbi medicine practice. The Sikbini doctor may add some new medicine to those already known. And whenever he discovers or invents a new remedy, he must perform a sacrifice, speaking thus, "God, the medicine that has been prepared, here it is. May the medicine be successful. I am sacrificing to Kepare. I am sacrificing to Tewane Melu. I am sacrificing to Teweko Dizane." The mention of invocation of ancestors in connection with the practice of medicine is a common feature. In the practice of medicine in many parts of Africa, it is an accepted practice that apart from God and or the divinity, the ancestors who first practiced medicine or who were past masters and teachers of medicine must be given due honor. It is believed that this makes still more for the efficacy of medicine. Thus, in Aliaife, the sacred city of the Yoruba, Alisiji, the first doctor and ancestral genius of medicine, is always invoked. Traditional doctors in Africa often claim that they are taught medicine by divinities or more generally in dreams or in trances, or during meetings with spirits in forests. There was a Yoruba doctor named Ajamaku, a man very well versed in Yoruba pharmacopoeia. This man claimed to have been carried away by the whirlwind into the world of spirits, where he remained for 7 years, feeding on alligator pepper and being taught medicine. His deformity he attributed to the twisting of his body during his painful ride in the whirlwind. Ajanaku certainly had a phenomenal power of memory. Whatever may be the truth of his story, there is no doubt that it emphasized the generally accepted belief that spirits do teach medicine to men of their own choice, whom they have called to be doctors. It is, of course, to be taken along with this that observations of nature and the discovery of causal links are certainly at the root of many magical and medicinal procedures. One fact which Ajanaku's story underlines is that a really good African doctor is usually a person who lives close to nature and has the opportunity of close observation, even though the medical habits of animals and birds. we just read from number 5, the practice of magic and medicine. We read from chapter 5, the structure of African traditional religion. We just read from the book titled African Traditional Religion and Definition, read by Dr. E. Manoj Adonu. I read from the book titled African Religions and Philosophy, written by Dr. John S. M. Beattie. Chapter 7, the worship of God, eight sacrifices and offerings. The nigga regard every event or occasion as suitable for sacrificing, and for them, every bull or ox is destined ultimately for sacrifice. Animal sacrifice is the central religious act of the nigger, whose cattle are in their eyes perfect victims as they give personal names to the cattle before one is killed. They announce to it the important and necessary prayer for one that is victimized and compensate it for his death by naming the next child after it, thus preserving his memory. Since cattle are as valuable as human beings, sacrificing them to God is as serious and purposeful as sacrificing a person. To the deacon, sacrifices are the perpetual link between the plane of man and the plane of God. The newer are also reported to have many occasions when they sacrifice to God. Cattle are the usual animals for this purpose, and on the important occasion, the people make long invocations. When a person is on a journey, he knots grasses together at the side of the path and prays to God. These are sufficient examples to illustrate how African people respond to the spiritual world through sacrifice and offerings. The items for sacrifice include cattle, sheep, goats, chickens, dogs, and even human beings. Items used for offerings include foodstuffs like fruits, maize, millet, nuts, cassava, vegetable leaves, honey, and eggs. Beverages like porridge, milk, beer, wine, and water, and other things of a miscellaneous nature, like the dog or the hyrax. Cloth, money, chalk, incense, agricultural implements, ornaments, tobacco, and cowrie shell. Blood is also offered by a noble, a society does almost everything that man can get hold of and use as sacrifice or offer to God and other spiritual beings by one people or another. As a rule, there are no sacrifices without prayers. Sacrifices and offerings are the silent response to prayers, or the verbal response, and to the latter, we should not proceed. Okay, we're going to read on to B. Prayers, invocation, blessings, and salutations. Praying may or may not always be accompanied by sacrifices and offerings. It is the commonest act of worship, and most African prayers are short, extempore, and to the point. There are also examples of long, informal prayers. The majority of prayers and invocations are addressed to God, and some to the living dead or other spiritual beings, many of whom serve as intermediaries. Praying is reported among practically all African peoples, though the actual prayers have not often been recorded in our written sources. We should take a few examples from different parts of the continent to illustrate the concepts and context of African prayers. Okay, I'm gonna stop right there. Okay, we started reading on B, prayers, invocation, blessings, salutation. We read A, sacrifice and offerings from chapter 7, the worship of God. And we read from the book titled African Religions and Philosophy, read by Dr. John S. M. Beebe. Continue our reading from the book titled Concepts of God in Africa, written by Dr. John S. M. Beebe. Read from number 17, worship, prayers, and other appeals to God. And we'll be reading from invocation and appeals. Punishing a witch publicly. The Bakongo make her drink a poisonous cup. And they invoke God, saying God is just and merciful. At the coronation of their king, the Bamun invoke God to bless the king, to grant him many children, to make his war spirit mighty and his work strong, to increase his wealth and to give him guidance. In addition to formal prayers, the Gale invoke God frequently in their conversation among the Ganda. When waking up, the head of the family looks up towards heaven and invokes God's blessing upon the household. When the spirits become notorious, the Kikuyu implore God to send them off. When invoking God, the Messiah frequently used their children to assist in the ceremony. The Banyamwanda believe that although God is a law, he intervenes in individual lives when he is invoked, and they invoke him as the God of the wonder. When there is a crisis in national or individual life, the Inca, the Ingesane, invoke God. For example, at the rainmaker ceremony, they say, God, give us rain. And the father or husband of a barren woman blesses her, saying, you want fruit. God, give you fruit. The Nube have an annual ceremony for blessing cattle in which they invoke God, saying, God, we are hungry. Give us cattle, give us sheep in one area of their country. It is believed that God causes the crops to grow when the rainmakers invoke him to do so. In another ceremony, they invoke him, saying, God, increase cattle, increase sheep, increase men. In their communal prayer, the Sunjo open with the invocation. Abe, Father. Rio, Abe. Kebe, Yio. When in difficulties or in extreme trouble, the Bakongo utter appeals to God, crying, for example, I wish God had never made me, or more positive, God, pity me. In moments of inspiration, such as sickness or misfortune, the vain wonder appeals to God, and these are similar words. I have done all to the spirits, and now I leave it in the hands of God alone. When the person prospers or recovers thereafter, he says, Hakazim, my name. It is only God who can save a man. If a person has lost something, he goes to a priest for help, and the priest appeals to God, saying, for the God of Rwanda's sake, we will succeed, will let us succeed. Then the priest approaches the lesser divinity, and these act as intermediary between God and the people in need. The Banyoro also appeal to the divinity instead of calling upon God for assistance. When the Balube appeal to God, they address him as, O great God. In time of public need, the Wajawa gather themselves to dance and call upon God for what is required, and the priest sacrifice a red carp. We'll stop right now. Okay, we just read from invocations and appeals. We read from number 17, worship, prayers, and other appeals to God. And we just read from part 4, God and man. Just read from the book title, Concepts of God in Africa, read by Dr. John H. Beatty. Just my chair. Now, we'll go to the dictionary. Now, I do have a Merriam-Webster dictionary. I do have a Merriam-Webster thesaurus. Good to have, you know. Meanwhile, in the house, sometimes you might write your letters. I'd be doing an email or something. You need to look up a word. Good at. But it's a, you know, in today's stage, you know, it's a little limited in its capabilities. So, and now we have, you know, advances, technological advances. We have the internet. So, you know, we go on that. So, we're going to go to the Merriam-Webster Dictionary, thesaurus.com, and also dictionary.com, thesaurus.com. And, you know, whatever, what, if you find another dictionary online, we go to them. No, we went to the law library, no law books, and we'll find some resources. Start out a dictionary with argument and argue. Now you have valid argument and you have an invalid argument. You have a deductive argument and you have an inductive argument. Conductive argument. You have an abductive argument. You have a sound argument. You have an unsound argument. You also have a defeasible argument, a transitional argument, and a transcendental argument. We also have a Rogerian, Toman, and classical argument. We have an Aristotelian or adversarial argument, or Rogerian or consensus building argument. We also have a practical argument. We also need to know what a premise is, a conclusion, a reference, and research. Words up. We're going to go over here to Wikipedia, etymology, and linguistics. Okay, linguistics. It's the scientific study of language. and involves an analysis of language form, language meaning, and language in context. The earliest activities in the documentation and description of language have been attributed to the 4th century BCE Indian grammarian Panini, who wrote a formal description of the Sanskrit language in his Hastinapurana. Now, when it comes to linguistics, you have theoretical, descriptive, applied, and experimental linguistics. Now, when it comes to etymology comes up under descriptive linguistics. So let's click over there to etymology. Etymology is the study of the history of words, their origin, and how their form and meaning have changed over time. By extension, the term, the etymology of a word, means the origin of the particular word. And let's click over here to the dictionary. Merriam-Webster dictionary argument. Now, Merriam-Webster, let's get the pronunciation.
Argument.
Argument. Now, the definition of argument, number one, A, the act or process of arguing, reasoning, or discussing. Argumentation. B, a coherent series of reasons, statements, or facts intended to support or establish a point of view. C, an angry quarrel or disagreement. Number two, A reason given for or against a matter under discussion. B, a form of rhetorical expression intended to convince or persuade. Number three, an abstract or summary, especially of a literary work. Number four, the subject matter, especially of a literary work. Number five, A, mathematics, one of the independent variables from whose value that of a function depends. B, grammar, a substantive, such as a direct object of a transitive verb that is required by a predicate and grammar. C, mathematics, amplitude. Number six, obsolete, an outward sign, indication. Now, we have related to argument. We have examples of argument in a sentence. Now we have the origin etymology of argument, Middle English, from Anglo-French, from Latin argumentum, from argue. Now over here to your right, you have argument synonyms. Let's click this origin etymology of argument. Our first known use, 14th century. Now you have argument defined for English language learners, argument defined for kids. Now the law dictionary, legal definition of argument, number one, A. Reason or the reason given for or against a matter under discussion, compare, evidence or proof. Number two, the act or process of arguing, reason or discussing, especially oral argument. Now let's click over to Merriam-Webster, thesaurus. Now the Merriam-Webster thesaurus does not give pronunciation. The argument is a noun. You have synonyms and antonyms of argument, and you also have related words. So let's click over here to dictionary.com. Okay, let's get the pronunciation.
Argument.
Argument. So now, number one, an oral disagreement, verbal opposition, contention, altercation. A violent argument. Number two, a discussion involving different points of view, debate. Number three, a process of reasoning, series of reasons. Number four, a statement, reason, or fact for or against a point. Number five, an address or composition intended to convince or persuade. Number six, subject matter, theme. Number seven, an abstract or some other major points in a work, or a prose or poetry or section of such a work. Now, the origin of argument is Old French, Middle English, and Latin. 1325, 75 Middle English. Old French, Latin, argumental. Then you have related words, synonyms, examples from the web for argument, the British dictionary definition for argument. Now, some people might want to go to the British dictionary. No. The word origin and history for argument, argumentative technology, and idioms and phrases for argument. Okay. And let's click over here to thesaurus.com. nuts.
Argument.
Argument. Now, thesaurus, dictionary.com and thesaurus.com both give pronunciation. Now, you got synonym for argument. You got antonym for argument. And you also have words related to argument. And over here to your right, word originate history, argument, late 14th century statements and reasoning. In support of a proposition, from French argument, from Latin argumentum, argument. Okay. Then you also have example sentences for argument. On the right there beneath. Word origin history. Now click back over here to Merriam-Webster. Dictionary, argue. Like I said, we're gonna look up gang, of course, gang, gangster, mobster, thug and goon and boss, and you know, but we're gonna look up free, slave, you know, free and freedom, slave, slavery, right, wrong, good, bad. Argue. Let's get the pronunciation. We're on Merriam-Webster dictionary.
Argue.
Argue. Now, argue is a verb. Definition of argue: intransitive verb, number one, to give reason for or against something. Reason. Number two, to contend or disagree in word, dispute. Transitive verb, number one, to give evidence of, indicate. Number two, to consider the pros and cons of, discuss. Number three, to prove or try to prove by giving reason, maintain. Number four, to persuade by giving reasons, induce. And you have examples of arguing in the sentence. Now, the origin and etymology of arguing, Middle English from Anglo-French, argue, to reprove, argue, and Latin, argue. To demonstrate, prove. Anglo-French, so on and so forth. First known use 14th century. And over here, right on the right there, argue synonyms. Synonym discussion of argument. Now you have phrase related to argue. Argue defined for English language learners. Argue defined for kids. Now you got a law dictionary for argue. Verb. Look at definition of argue. Intransitive verb. Number one, to give reason for or against a matter in dispute. Number two, to present a case in court. Transitive verb, number one, A, to give reason for or against. B, to prove or try to prove by giving reason or evidence. Number two, to present in court. Lawyers in court, filing briefs and arguing appeals, okay? Okay, Merriam-Webster thesaurus. Argue, a verb. Now you got synonyms and antonyms of argue. And you also have words that are related to argue. Now let's click over here to dictionary.com. Let's get the pronunciation of argue.
Argue.
A verb used without object. Number one, to present a reason for or against a thing. Number two, to contend in oral disagreement, dispute. Verb used with object. Number three, to state the reason for or against. Number four, to maintain a reason. Number five, to persuade, drive, etc. by reason. Number six, to show, prove, imply, indicate. Origin of argue. 1275. 1325, Middle English, Anglo-French, Old French, argue, Latin, argutare, so on and so forth. Now you have related forms, you have synonyms, you have example from the web for argue, you have the British Dictionary definition for argue, word origin history for argue, And let's click over here to start.com. Get the pronunciation.
Argue.
Now you got argue, synonym for argue, antonym for argue, and you have words related to argue. Now over here to your right, you have the word originate history, argue, 13th century. Old French argue, from Latin argue, terras, or battle, freezer. Okay? Now you have example sentences for argue. Now let's click back over here to Merriam-Webster Dictionary. The word that we want to make sure we continue to emphasize and put focus on, game. Merriam-Webster dictionary, thesaurus.com. Okay, we're on dictionary.com. Merriam-Webster dictionary. Get the pronunciation. Gang.
Gang.
Gang is a verb. The definition of gang. Scotland. In transit of verb. Go. Relating to gang. Now you have the origin and etymology of gang. Middle English. From Old English. Ganging. A king of Lithuania, a zinc type to stride, first known to before 12th century. Excuse me. Now you have gang as a noun. The definition of gang, number one, a set of articles, outfit, a gang of oars. Number two, a combination of similar implements or devices arranged for convenience to act together, a gang of saws. B, group. Such as, number one, a group of persons working together. Number two, a group of persons working to unlawful or antisocial ends, especially a band of antisocial adolescents. Number two, a group of persons having informal and usually close social relations while teaming with the gang. You have examples of gang in the sentence, the origin and etymology of gang, Middle English, walking, journey. From Old English, kings of Old English, ganging, first known use 14th century. Gang as a verb, the definition of gang, transitive verb, number one, A, to assemble, operate simultaneously as a group, B, to arrange in or produce as a gang, number two, to attack in a gang. Hoodlums ganged him and took his money. Now, intransitive verb, to move or act as a gang. The origin and etymology of gang. Gang number two. Gang defined for English language learners. Gang defined for kids. The law dictionary is what we're looking at. The law dictionary. Gang as a noun. Legal definition of gang. A group of persons associated for antisocial and often criminal purposes and activities. Okay. Now let's click over here. The Merriam-Webster Thesaurus. Yeah, gang as a noun. And you have synonyms and antonyms for gang and also related words. Click over at dictionary.com. Okay, we're on dictionary.com. You get a pronunciation?
Gang.
Okay, now, number one, a group or band. Number two, a group of youngsters or adolescents who associate closely, often exclusively for social reasons. Especially such a group engaged in delinquent behavior. Number three, a group of people with compatible tastes or mutual interests who gather together for social reasons. Number four, a group of persons working together, squad, ship. Number six, they sell tools, electronic components, or circuits, ores, etc., arranged to work together or simultaneously. Number seven, a group of identical or related items. Verb, used with objects. Number eight, to arrange in groups or sets, form into a gang. Number nine, to attack in a gang. Verb used without object, tend to form or act as a gang. Verb phrasing, number 11, gang up on. The origin of gang, Middle English, Old English, 1300-1350. Middle English, Old English, gang, gone. Manner of going, way, a passage. Cognate with Old High German, gang, Old Norse, ganger, got the gang. Now you have synonyms. You have gang, verb, you without object. Chiefly Scottish and Northern and North and North England. Number one, to walk or go. Origin before 900 Middle English, gang of Old English, ganging, gonging. Cognate with Old High German, gang gang. Old Norse, gang gang. Gothic, gang gang. Okay. Example from the web for gang. British Dictionary definition for gang. Word origin and history for gang. Slang definition phrase for gang. Idioms and phrases with gang. Get the pronunciation, we'll, thesaurus.com, gang, pronunciation, gang. Okay, you have synonym for gang, you have antonym for gang, and you have words related to gang. Now, over here to your right, you have your word origin and history. Let me click expand here. Now, gang, Old English, gone, and going, journey, way. Passage and Old Norse gang, gangra, a group of men and sent both from Genghis. Now, you have gangway, preserved the original sense of the word is the gangplank, replacing earlier gang board. So on and so forth. Then you have example sentences for gang. Okay, let's click back over here to Merriam-Webster Dictionary. Gangster. Merriam-Webster Dictionary. Okay, let's get the pronunciation.
Gangster.
Gangster. Okay, the definition of gangster, a member of a gang of criminals, a racketeer. Okay, you can look the racketeer up. Okay, you have examples of gangster in a sentence. First known use of gangster, 1884. And then right there to your right, gangster synonyms. Okay, you have gangster defined for English language learners. You have gangster defined for kids. Now the law dictionary. Pay attention. Gangster. Legal definition of gang. A member of a gang of criminals. That's the legal definition for law dictionary. And when we look up these other words like mob and monster, thug, goon, drugs. There's no legal definition. Okay, let's click over here to thesaurus.com. Merriam-Webster thesaurus. Merriam-Webster thesaurus. Gangster is a noun. You have synonyms and antonyms of gangster. Let's click over here to dictionary.com. Okay, let's get the pronunciation.
Gangster.
Gangster. It's a noun. Number one, a member of a gang of criminals, especially a racketeer. The origin of gangster. 1895-1900. Pay attention. 1895-1900. Americanism, gang plus stir. You have synonyms. Examples from the web from gangster. The British Dictionary definition for gangster. Word origin history for gangster. Slang definition phrase for gangster. Okay, just click over here at thesaurus.com. Okay, let's click the pronunciation.
Gangster.
Gangster. Now you have synonym for gangster. You have antonym for gangster. You have words related to gangster. Now over here to your right, the word origin and history. Of gang in this criminal sense. American English from gang, and it's cruel sense, gang lady. It's from 1912. Okay. Now you have example sentences for gangster. Back over here to Merriam-Webster. The mob. Mob is a noun. Let's get the pronunciation.
Mob.
Mob. Now you have definition of mob. Number one, a large or disorderly crowd, especially one bent on rioting or destructive acts. Number two, the lower class of a community, mass and rabble. Number three, chiefly Australian flock, drove or herd of animals. Number four, a criminal set gang, especially often capitalized. Number five, inform a group of people, crowd. Examples of mob in a sentence. The origin and etymology of mob, Latin mobile focus, facilitating crowd. First known use, 1688. And then right there to your right, mob synonyms. Oops. Then you have synonym discussion of mob. Then you have mob definition of mob. Number one, transitive verb. Number one, to crowd about and attack or annoy. Mob by autograph hunters. Number two, to crowd into or around. Customer mob store on sale day. Okay. Examples of mob in the Senate. First known use of mob, 1696. And then right there to your right, we have mob synonym. Many are phrases related to mob. Mob defined for English language learners. Mob is a verb. Mob defined for kids. Then definition mob for students. Okay. And no legal definition. Okay, let's click over here to Merriam-Webster thesaurus. Sorry, mob. For now, synonyms and antonyms of mob, as well as you have other words related to mob. Click over to dictionary.com. pronunciation.
Mob.
Mob. It's a noun, number one, a disorder around this crowd of people. Number two, a crowd bent on or engaged in lawless violence. Number three, in a group or condition of persons or things. Number four, a club of people, the masses, populace, or multitude. Number five, a criminal gang. Expression one involved in drug trafficking, extortion, seven. Number six, the mob, mafia. Number seven, sociology, and group of persons stimulating one another to incite and lose an ordinary rational control over their activity. An adjective, number nine, of related to a characteristic of a lawless, irrational, disorder, or riotous crowd. Okay. Number 10, directed at or reflecting the lowest intellectual level of the common people. Verb used with object. Number 12, to attack in a riotous mob. Number 13, fox under the chop. The origin of mob, 1689, short for Latin mobile bogus, the movable, changeable, and constant color of people. Mob, digital technology. Origin. Example from the web for mob. British dictionary definition for mob. Mob, abbreviation, word, order, history for mob. Slang, definition, phrase for mob. Related abbreviation for mob. Okay. Now, click over to thesaur.com. Now you have a synonym for mob, you got antonym for mob, and you got words related to mob. Now you have the word oil to your right, you have the word origin in history. Mob, 1680, is disorderly part of the population rabble, slain, shortened up mobile, mobility, common people, populist rabble, from Latin mobile bogus, fickle, common people. 1600 English for mobile, neutral mobiles. Pick a movable mobile from mobile, you know, other words. Spain. Okay. Now you have example sentence for mob. Example sentence for mob. Okay. Well, let me start this one at the same time. Okay. Let's go real. Okay, let's go back over to Merriam-Webster. Merriam-Webster Dictionary. Let's get the pronunciation. Monster. Monster.
Mobster.
Mobster. The definition of mobster, remember, of a criminal gang. Examples of mobster in the sentence. First known use of mobster, 1917. Then right there to your right, mobster synonym. Then you have mobster defined for English language learners. Okay. I click Merriam-Webster Thesaurus. Mobster is a noun. You have synonyms, antonyms of mobster. They have related words for mobster. Now click over at dictionary.com. Get the pronunciation.
Mobster.
Mobster. Okay, is a noun, number one, a member of a criminal mob. The origin of mobs, 1915-1920, Americanism, mob plus stir. We have examples from the web for mobster. You have British dictionary definition for mobster. We have word of origin and history for mobs. We have slang definition and phrases for mobs. I click over here to thesaurus.com. Let's get the pronunciation.
Mobster.
Mobster. We have synonym for mobster. Antonym for mobster. We have words related to mobster. Now over here to your right, the word origin and history. Mobster, 1917, for mob in the criminal sense, plus stir. Okay? And then you have some example sentences for mobster. Now click over here to Merriam-Webster. Get the pronunciation.
Thug.
Thug. Now you have a definition of thug, a brutal ruffian or assassin, gangster or tough. Related to thug, example of thug in the sentence. The origin etymology of thug, Hindi and Urdu, thag, literally a thief. First known use 1810, over right to your right. Thug synonyms. You got thug defined by English language learners. The definition of, what is it called? We have thug defined for kids. Okay. Click over that thesaurus. Remember what's the thesaurus. Thug noun. Synonyms and antonyms of thug. Okay. And related words. Dictionary.com. Dictionary.com, your pronunciation.
Thug.
Thug. It's a noun. Number one, a cruel or vicious ruffian, robber, or murderer. Number two, sometimes initial capital letter, one of a former group of professional robbers and murderers, an enemy who strangled their victims. The origin of thug, Hindi, 1800, 1810. Okay, 1800, Hindi, thag, mineral, rogue, or cheap, related forms. Example from the web for thug. British dictionary definition for thug. Word origin. Word origin and history for thug. Now click over at thesaurus.com. Get the pronunciation.
Thug.
Thug. Now you have synonyms for thug. Antonym for thug and words related to thug. No, over here to your right, word origin and history thug, 1810, member of a gang of murderers and robbers and Indians who strangled them victims from Rathi, Thag, Thack, Cheat, Swindler, Hindi, Thag, so on. Okay. Now you have an example sentence for thug. Now get back, click back over here to Merriam-Webster. Goon. Okay, let's get the pronunciation. From Merriam-Webster Dictionary.
Goon.
Number one, definition of goon. Number one, a stupid person. Number two, A man hired to terrorize and eliminate opponents. B, enforcer. Related to goon, examples of goon in a sentence. Origin and etymology of goon, probably short for English dialect. Goon is similar to first known, used 1921, right there to your right. Goon synonym. Goon defined for English language learners. Click over the Merriam-Webster thesaurus. And we have goon as a noun. We have synonyms and antonyms of goon and words related to goon. I click over here to dictionary.com. Get the pronunciation.
Goon.
Goon. Okay, so now, number one, informant, hired, hoodlum, or thug. Number two, slang, a stupid, foolish, or awkward person, B, a roughneck. The origin of goon, 1920-1925, short from dialect goonie, bearing the obsolete, goonie, a simpleton. Influenced by the comic strip character, Alice the Goon, in the series Thimble Theater. E.C. Siegel, 1894-1938, American cartoonist. We have an example from the web for goon. British dictionary definition for goon. Word origin and history for goon. Slang definition and phrase for goon. Okay? Thesaurus.com. Get a pronunciation.
Goon.
Goon. Yeah, synonym for goon, antonym for goon, words related to goon. Over here to your right, word origin and history. Goon, 1921, stupid person, from goon to simpleton. 1580 of unknown origin, but applied by sailors to the albatross and similar. Big clumsy birds, 1839, since a hired thug, first recorded. 1938, in reference to Union. Beef squads used to cow strikers in the Pacific Northwest. Proper Addis the Goon, slow-witted and muscular, with gentle nature character, and Thimble Theater comic strip, starring Popeye by E.C. Siegel, 1894-1938. Okay. Now you have an example sentence for Goon. Now let's go over here to Merriam-Webster. Boss. Merriam-Webster Dictionary. Let's get the pronunciation.
Boss.
It's a noun. Definition of boss, number one. A. A protuberant part or body. B. A raised ornamentation. C. An ornamental projecting block used in architecture. Number two, a salt pan used in ceramics and glass making. Three, the hub of a propeller. Did you know the Dutch settlements in North America all came under English rule in the 1660s and 1670s, but Dutch continued to be spoken in the region long afterward in America, English. The lexical heritage of the Dutch colonies include dope, stoop, meaning porch, and Santa Claus. Perhaps the most pervasive Dutch known word is boss, from the Dutch boss, meaning master. The word first appears in the form boss. 1806, viewed by Weissner, part of its success seems to have resulted from an American aversion to master, which was common in British youth. Okay, the origin etymizing boss, Middle English, boss, from Anglo-French, from Vulgar Latin, bossa, first known use 14th century. Now, boss of the bird, definition of boss, translate the bird, the more to embellish. With a raised decoration to ornament with bosses. Number two, the tree has a circular portion with a boss. Or the etymology of boss, first known use 15 cents, boss noun. Definition about number one, a person who exercises control or authority, union boss, and mafia boss. Simply one with the ranks of supervised work. That's the boss for rank. Okay. Number two, politics, one who controls votes and a part of the organization dictates a point. Appointments or legislative measures stand up to the power. Okay. The origin etymizing boss, Dutch, boss master. First known use 1653. And write that to you right here. Other business terms. Boss is an adjective, definition of boss slang. Excellent, first rate. Example of boss in the center. Origin etymizing boss. Boss synonym, boss definition of boss. The bird transferring the will to inside control authority over to act as boss. I need someone to boss that job. Number two, to be unusual. Arbitrary orders to usually use around. Or to analyze the boss. Boss is not a definite boss. Cow, calf. Or to analyze the boss. Or the animal husband turn. Okay. Phrase related to boss. Boss defined for English language learners. Boss. Boss defined for kids. Medical dictionary for boss. Okay. Now let's go to Merriam-Webster thesaurus. Oh, tilt it over again. Okay. Now, phrases related to boss. Then you have boss defined for English language learners, boss defined for kids. Now, the dictionary for boss. Okay, let's click over in the mirror and go to thesaurus. Adjective, synonyms and antonyms of boss. And then you have some related words to boss. Now, click over to dictionary.com. Get the pronunciation. Boss.
Boss.
Boss. It's a noun. Number one, a person who employs or superintends workers, manager. Number two, a politician who controls a part of the organization as in a particular district. Number three, a person who makes decisions, inside authority, dominates, etc. Verb used with object. Number four, to be master of or over, manage, direct, control. Number five, to order about, especially in an arrogant manner. Verb used with an object. Number six, to be boss. Number seven, to be too domineering and authoritative. Adjective. Number eight, chief, master. Nine, slave, first rate. The origin of boss is Dutch. 1640-50, Americanism, Dutch, boss, master, foreman. Synonyms, boss, noun. Okay, boss, synonyms, motion, noun, origin. Then you have examples from the web for boss. British Dictionary definition for boss. Boss in medicine, slang, definitely afraid of boss, boss in technology. Now click over at thesaurus.com. Okay, let's get the pronunciation.
Boss.
Boss. Synonym for boss, antonym for boss, words related to boss, oriental erratic word ordinary to boss, overseer 1640. American English from Dutch, boss, and master. And then you have example sentences for boss. Okay, what I'm going to do now, before it cuts out, I'm gonna go ahead and stop the Periscope. Then I'm going to start it back. I'm going to stop Periscope, and I'm going to start it back. sure. Back in bed. We started Periscope. Okay. Now, if you look up some words, if you look up free, freedom, slave, slavery. You understand? Right, wrong, good and bad. And you can throw in that law and crime. So, yeah. So let's go ahead. Let's get there. Let me start free and free. We're on Merriam-West Dictionary. We're on Merriam-West Dictionary, and we're on free. Free. Let's get a pronunciation.
Free.
Free. It's an adjective. Definition of free, number one, A, having the legal and political rights of a citizen, sending slavery, okay, B, enjoying civil and political liberty, C, enjoying political independence or freedom from outside domination, D, enjoying personal freedom, not subject to the control or domination of another, okay, number two, A, not determined by anything beyond its own nature or being, choosing or capable of choosing for itself. B, determined by the choice of the actor or performer. C, made, done, or given voluntarily or spontaneously. Number three, A, relieved from or lacking something, especially something unpleasant or burdensome. Okay. B, not bound, confined, or detained by force. Number four, A, having no trade restriction. B, not subject to government regulation. C, a foreign exchange, not subject to restriction or official control. Number five, A, having no obligation as to work or commitments. B, not taking up with commitments or obligation. Number six, having a scope not restricted by qualification. Number seven, A, not obstructed, restricted, or impeded. B, not being used or occupied. C, not hampered or restricted in its normal operation. Number eight, A, not fastened. B, not confined to a particular position or place. C, capable of moving or turning in any direction. D, performed without apparatus. E, done with artificial aids, used only for protection against falling and not for support. Okay. Number nine, A, mouse. Parsimonious. B, outspoken. C, availing myself of something without stint. D, frank, open. E, openly familiar or forward in action or attitude. Four, licentious. And this is what Free talked about before, okay? Number 10, not costing or charging anything. Number 11, A, united with, attached to, combined with, or mixed with something else. B, chemically uncombined. C, not permanently attached but unable to move about. D, capable of being used alone as meaningful linguistic form. Number 12, A, not literal or exact. B, not restricted by or performing to conventional form. 13, favorable to use of a wind blowing from a direction from 6 points from the end to end. Number 14, not allowing slavery. Number 15, open to all comers, their most pleasurable Anglo-Saxon pastime. Okay. Now, do you have examples of free in a sentence? Can something be for free? The word free is often encountered on the heels of the word for. In this combination, since some people's teeth on edge, the main objection to the phrase for free is that in this instance, free functions as an adverb rather than a noun, and therefore should not be in an intimate company of the preposition for. Oh, it's not a reason. More correct phrase would be to say that something is offered for nothing, for no charge, or some other combination of preposition plus noun. Unfortunately for critics of the expression, English users do not agree. Despite its recent adoption in the mid-20th century and its informality for free, is in widespread use and generally accepted as standard speech and writing. The order etymology of free, Middle English from Old English, frio, akin to Old High German, fry, free, Welsh, ride, Sanskrit, priya, old, known, okay? First known use before 12th century. To your right, you got free synonyms. Synonym discussion of free. Definition of free. Transverb 1a, to cause to be free, b, to relieve or rid of what restrains, confines, restricts, or embarrasses from debt. C, disentangle. Number 2, obsolete, vanish. Okay. Several free in the center, or the etymology of free. And then over there to your right, free synonym, synonym discussion of free. Free definition of free. Examples of free in a sentence. Phrases related to free. Free defined for English language learners. Okay. Free defined for kids. Free. Medical dictionary free. Now, we have a law dictionary free. Legal definition of free. Number 1A. Having the legal political rights of a citizen. B. Enjoying civil and political liberty. C. Enjoying political independence or freedom from outside domination. D. Not subject to the control of domination of another. Number 2. Made or done as a matter of choice and right, not compelled or restricted. No law, okay. Number 3. Relieved from or lacking in burden. Number 4. Not bound, confined, or detained by force. Number 5. A. Having no trade restriction. B. Not subject to government regulation. C. A foreign state, not subject to restriction or official control. Number 6. Not costing or charging anything. Free transfer, legal definition of free. Free in one, to cause to be free. Number 2, to relieve or rid of what constrains, confines, restricts, or burdens. Okay. Now click over Merriam-Webster's thesaurus. Free is an adjective. You have synonyms and antonyms of free and words related to free. Okay. We also have free as a verb. Okay. Now let's click over here to dictionary.com. Okay, let's get a pronunciation. Enjoying personal rights and liberty is a person who is not enslaved. Number 2, pertain to or reserved for those who enjoy personal liberty. Number 3, existing under, carried around by or possessing civil and political liberty that is, there are, as a rule, constitutionally guaranteed by representative of government. Number 4, enjoying political autonomy as the people of country not under foreign rule independent. Number 5, exempt from external authority and interference. Restricted, etc., as a person or one's will, thought, choice, action, independent, unrestricted. 6, able to do something at will and liberty. Number 7, clear of obstructions or obstacles as a road or corner. And verse 37, the free man freely, 38, nautical away from the wind, so they say the best need not be close. Number 6, verb, you with object. 39, to make free, tilt it over again. Used with object 39 to make free, set and limited, release from bondage, imprisonment, or restraint. 40 to accept or deliver. Okay, 41 to relieve or rid. 42 to disengage, clear. Okay, verb phrase number 43, free up. And to release as from restriction, B to disentangle. Then you got idioms. I'm not gonna read all those. Okay, now the origin of free. Before 900 Middle English, free, old English, free up. Cognate with Gothic, Freaks, Old High German, Fire German, Freak, Dutch, Sanskrit. Now you got synonym, study, example from the web for free. Read a dictionary for free. Word origin history for free. Slang definition of phrase for free. Get them phrase for, okay, click over to sorry.com. Free, that's good pronunciation.
Free.
Then you have synonyms for free, antonyms for free, words related to free, word order over here to your right, word order history free, old English free, old free, exempt from, not in bondage, also noble joy. And then now you have an example sentence for free. Now to go over here to Merriam-Webster. Freedom. Merriam-Webster dictionary, freedom. Good pronunciation.
Freedom.
Freedom. Definition of freedom, number 1. The quality or state of being free, such as A, the absence of necessity, coercion, or constraint in choice or action. B, liberation from slavery or restraint or from the power of another. C, the quality or state of being exempt or released really from something onerous. D, ease, facility. The name, okay. D, the quality of being frank, open, or outspoken. B, F, improper familiarity. G, boldness or a conception or execution. H, unrestricted use. Number 2, A, and political right. B, franchising. Okay. Then you have examples of freedom and sentence. Origin, etymology of freedom. C, free, first, unused, blessing. Synonym, discussion of freedom. You also have freedom synonyms. Related freedom, freedom to fight for kids, law dictionary, freedom. Legal definition of freedom, number 1. The quality of state of being free as A, the absence of necessity, coercion, or constraint in choice or action. B, liberation from slavery or restraint or from the power of another. C, the quality or state of being exempt or released from something onerous. Number 2, A, the political or civil right. B, franchise. Now, click over here to Merriam-Webster Thesaurus. Now, freedom, noun, synonyms and antonyms of freedom, and you have words that related to freedom, now to click over into dictionary.com.
Freedom.
Okay. Now, number one, the state of being free or at liberty rather than in confinement or under physical restraint. Number two, exemption from external control, interference, regulation. Number three, the power to determine action without restraint. Number four, political or national independence. Number five, personal liberty as opposed to bondage or slavery. Number six, exempted from the presence of anything specified. Number seven, the absence of or release from ties or obligations. Origin of freedom, Middle English, Old English. 4900. Freedom. Freedom. Okay, synonyms. Example from the Web for Freedom. British Dictionary Definition for Freedom. Word Origin History for Freedom. Freedom in the Bible. Okay, thesaurus.com.
Freedom.
Freedom. Synonym for freedom. Antonym for freedom. Concept of thoughts or word freedom. Words related to freedom. Now, over here to your right, word origin history, freedom, old English freedom. Freedom rider reporting, okay? As I'm a sentence for freedom. Let's click back over to Merriam-Webster. Slave. Slave. We get a pronunciation.
Slave.
Merriam-Webster Dictionary. Slave. Let's pronounce that. Okay. Definition of slave. Number one. A person held in servitude as a child of another. Number two. One that is completely subservient to a dominating influence. Number three. A device. As the printer of a computer that is directly responsive to another. Number four. Judge. Toiler. Example. Slave in the Senate. Origin. Etymizer. Slave. Middle English. Slave. From Anglo-French or medieval Latin, Anglo-French. Esclave from medieval Latin, esclavus. Slav from the frequent enslavement of slaves in Central Europe during the early. First known use 14th century. Yeah, synonyms to your right. Okay, slave is a verb. A transitive verb. One, archaic, enslave. Number two, to make it directly respond to another mechanism. A transitive verb. One, to work like a slave. Number two, to traffic in slave. Example, slave in a sentence. First known use of slave. 1602, slave. Synonym, slave. Geographical name. Definition of slave. Phrase related slave, slave, the five for English language learner, slave, the five for kids, slave verb. Now, there was no legal definition. There was no legal definition in Merriam-Webster Dictionary. There was no legal definition. Now, click over to Merriam-Webster Thesaurus. Now, you got synonyms and antonyms of slave, and words related to slave. That's for all your slave noun, slave with a verb. Okay, click over here to dictionary.com. Okay, get the noun saying slave.
Slave.
Slave. Now, number one, a person who is the property of and wholly subject to another, a bond servant. Number two, a person entirely under the domination of some influence or person. Number three, a drudge. Number four, a slave. And number five, photographers. Subsidiary flash lamp. Activated through its photoelectric cell when the principal flash lamp is discharged. and a sixth machine and mechanism under control of and repeating the actions of a similar mechanism. For use without option. Number seven, to work like a slave, drudge. Number eight, to engage in a slave trade, procure, transport, or sell slave. Verb used without option. Number nine, to connect a machine to a master as a slave. Number 10, archaic to a slave. Origin of slave, Middle English, medieval Latin. Okay. Example from the web for slave. British dictionary definition for slave. Word origin and history for slave. Slave, slang, definitely in the phrase book. A slave, not a slave in a Bible. MarkTheSour.com. Okay, get pronunciation.
Slave.
Slave. Now you have synonym for slave. Antonyms for slave, male, words related to slave. Over here to your right, you have the word origin and history of slave, 12-90 person who is the property of another from Old French, enslaved, from Middle Latin, slavish, slave. Okay. So you may have an example sentence for slave. Now let's go back over here to Merriam-Webster. Slavery. Okay, let's get to pronunciation for slavery. Well, Merriam-Webster dictionary.
Slavery.
Slavery. Definition of slavery. Number one, drudgery, toil. Number two, submission to a dominating influence. Number three, A, the state of a person who is a chattel of another. B, the practice of slaveholding. Examples of slavery in a sentence. First known use of slavery, 1551. Yeah, slavery synonym. Slavery defined for English language learners. Slavery defined for kids. Okay. Now, there's no legal definition. No legal click over to Merriam-Webster thesaurus. Synonyms and antonyms of slavery noun. Okay. Click over to dictionary.com.
Slavery.
It's a noun. Number one, the condition of a slave, bondage. Number two, the keeping of slaves at the practice or institution. Number three, a state of subjection, like that of a slave. Number four, severe toil, drudgery, origin of slavery. 1545, 1515. Okay, slavery plus Erie. Slave plus Erie. Slave plus Erie. Okay, related to synonyms. Examples from the web for slavery. Slavery. British dictionary definition for slavery. Word origin and history for slavery. Okay. Let's go over to thesaurus.com. Pronunciation.
Slavery.
Slavery. Synonym for slavery. Antonyms for slavery. Words related to slavery. Okay. Now over here to your right, there's no word origin or history, but you do have example sentences for slavery. So let's click back over here to Merriam-Webster. the definition of right. Boy, I scrolled out. What? Okay, let's get pronunciation.
Right.
Right. Okay, number one, righteous, upright. Number two, being in accord with what is just, good, or proper. Number three, conforming to facts or truth, correct. Number four, suitable, appropriate. Number five, straight. Number six, genuine or real. Number seven, eight, related to, suited, situated on, or being the side of the body which is away from the side on which the heart is mostly located, being located nearer to the right hand and to the left. C, located to the right of an observer or facing us. I've just specified the rating as the right or point. When raised out to the side, D, number one, located on the right of an observer facing in the same direction is the object specified, located on the right or facing downstream, the right bank of a river. E, done with the right hand. Number eight, having the axis perpendicular to the base. Number nine, related to or constituting the principal or more prominent side of an object. 10, acting or judging in accordance with truth or fact. Number 11, 8, being in good physical or mental health or order. B, being in a correct or proper state. 12, most favorable or desired. 13, often capitalized. Okay, example of writing a sentence. Now, the origin example or etymology of right is Middle English from Old English, right, or king to Old High German. Okay, Latin rectus, straight. Number 12th century, right, the synonym. The synonym discussion of writing. Okay, you have writing as a noun. Okay, it's just 2 minutes. Okay, for right now. Okay. Time won't permit me to read all those. Okay, it's that one, writing the sentence, origin and etymology of right. Middle English from Old English, right, from right in general. Okay, then you got some more right as an adverb. Don't write the sentence, right, write the verb. Some write phrases related to write, write the five for English language learners, write as a noun, write as an adverb, write as a verb, write the five for kids, write as a noun, write as an adverb, write as a verb, medical dictionary for write, the law dictionary for write. Legal definition of right. Number one, A, qualities that together constitute the ideal of moral property or merit. Moral improvement, B, something that is morally just. Number two, something to which one has just claim. A, power, privilege, or conditional existence to which one has a natural claim of enjoyment or possession. B, a power, privilege, immunity, or capacity that enjoyment which is secured to a person by law. C, a legally enforceable claim against another that the other will do or will not do a given act. D, the entry that one has in a property claim or title of the property or use of pool. The entry that property possess in an intangible thing, an expression of item or intellectual property. A privilege given stockholders to subscribe or rather to a new issue of security. General Lamar, okay, or the advisor, right? Now take over the Miriam Webster. Okay, right is an adjective. We have synonyms, antonyms, or right. Words related to right. Then you have right as an adverb. Right as a noun. Okay. Now click over at dictionary.com.
Right.
Right. Oh boy. Right. 61 definition. Okay. Time won't permit. Well, as you can see, the origin of right. There's just too many definitions for me to read right now. I'm running out of time. Now you have examples from the web for right. Read a dictionary definition for right. Word origin history for right. Old English. German, so on and so forth. Idioms and phrases for right. Okay, let's go to thesaurus.com.
Right.
Right. We got synonym for right. We got antonym for right. Usage note. Concept of sorry for word right. Words related to right. Now here, word origin history over here to your right. Right. Morally correct. Old English right. Just good, fair, proper, feeling straight. Okay. Example sentences for right. Now let's do wrong. Okay, let's get the pronunciation wrong.
Wrong.
Wrong. Definition wrong, number one. An injurious, unfair or unjust act, action or conduct inflicted harm without due provocation or just cause, be a violation or invasion of the legal rights of another. Number two, something wrong in a moral or ethically, special principle, practice or conduct contrary to justice, goodness, equity or law. Number three, state, position, or fact of being or doing wrong, such as A, state of being mistaken or incorrect, B, the state of being guilty. Now, examples of wrong in the sentence, origin, etymology, wrong, Middle English, from Old English, rain, from rain, adjective of rain, first known use, 12th century. Now, over here to your right, you got wrong, synonym, discussion of wrong, wrong is an adjective. Examples of wrong in the sentence. Or is it etymology wrong adverb? Okay, let's see. Wrong is a verb. Wrong five in English language learner. Wrong adjective. Wrong adverb. Wrong five for kids. Wrong noun. Wrong adverb. The law dictionary for wrong. Legal definition of wrong number one. A violation of the rights of another, especially tort. Number two, something as conduct, practice, or violence, contrary to justice, goodness, equity, or law, the difference between right and wrong. Wrong, transfer, legal definition of wrong, to do a wrong, to treat with injustice. Okay. Now, Merriam-Webster, thesaurus. As synonyms and antonyms of wrong. Wrong is an adverb, wrong is a noun. Click over here to dictionary.com. Okay, let's get the pronunciation from wrong. All those origin of wrong, Middle English, Old Danish, rain, perhaps Danish, rain, wrong. Okay. Example from the web for wrong, British dictionary definition for wrong, word origin history for wrong, idiom and phrase for wrong. Okay. Thesaurus.com. Let's get pronunciation.
Wrong.
We got synonym for wrong. Antonym for wrong. We got concept of sorry for word wrong. Words related to wrong. And then over here to your right, we got the word origin and history wrong. Late Old English, twisted, crooked. Right. The Old Norse. Wrong. Pretty wrong. Now you have an example citizen from Rome. Now time won't permit for good and bad. So on my next video, when we come back, we're gonna get good and bad and law and crime. And time won't permit, I won't be able to read the scripture, but what I'm gonna do is make reference as to inform you know, or make sure I let everybody know that we're gonna continue put our emphasis and focus on anti-gang and in the houses of worship. Gangs are not allowed, criminals not allowed. You refer to the King James Bible, and you can go to the Old Testament in the book of Genesis. And we talk about the flood story. And starts on starting in chapter 6. Starts in chapter 6, starting in verse number 1. And it ends in verse number 22. And then you also will read chapter 7 and chapter 8 on the flood story. And nobody can tell you that it ain't nothing wrong being another gang and sitting in the house of worship, and specifically the Church of Christ. That's a lie. It's a lie. And then, when Jesus is the Son of God, he started teaching the multitude and his disciples, okay? The Beatitudes, the New Testament. Go to the book of Matthew, starting at chapter 5, but you can read chapter 4, and start at chapter 5, verse number 1, the Beatitude, and start from verse 48, also read chapter 6. And chapter 7. On the Beatitude. Then also go to the book of Luke. So go to the book of Luke and go start at chapter 6. Let me have to read the whole chapter. And then the Beatitudes will start at verse number 20 all the way to verse 49. Give it an end of the day video. Again, my name is Eric D. Johnson, also known by Shine here, right here in the city of Memphis. It's in the county of Shelby. It's in the state of Tennessee. And I thank all my fans, my support for the continued encouragement and support. And to my next video, take care of yourself. I wish each and every one of you the very best.